So, let's return to that area. Ignore the guys in the poison mist, cross the bridge and find the dude. Like, I could actually avoid fighting this dude too, but not particularly hard. And then I want to head into this room where I engage two more of those, pass through and entered, quote, Earthen Peak, unquote. An interesting zone, but one with an evil poison lake which will instantly kill you if you fall into it. Ooh. Well, it's much better to not get hit by that. Now, I can't help but notice that my face has been replaced with a really cool sun icon. As if I was officially being marked by my cool covenant as being cool. I don't think I wouldn't like get anything out of this covenant at all, but I might actually stay in it anyway. I do like doing co-op. I like the idea of being summoned more easily for it. So, what if I were to jump that way? Maybe not. Maybe not right now. I think I'll come back there after looking for other things. Harvest Valley. Oh man, there's a windmill right here. It's cool. I wonder if I can get it. It's made of wood too. Could I get a guy to smash it? Throw a firebomb. I don't think I'm really in position to hit it though. Just try. I think if I'd actually aimed correctly, that would have hit it. Hmm. It's kind of hard to aim though. Okay, enough wasting firebombs. So. He doesn't seem to mind getting poisoned. When the same thing happened to some pirates in No Man's Wharf, they got completely wrong. I think they died of the poison themselves. But this guy is clearly not particularly vulnerable to it. Hmm. So I'm actually above the other room. Does this also lead into Earthen Peak, perhaps to a safer part of Earthen Peak? Yes, it does. Okay. Good to know. They emit clouds of poison, and that's what that was going on here. Pretty sure they emit clouds of poison. Whoa! What's he doing in there? These guys could stand to wear more. They look. Sadly, they remind me of Lenegrast a little. Like, you know, big hammer, no shirt, covered in green. Thankfully, he's not as far gone. Hey, that's a fog door. But I think probably just the progress further into an area kind of fog door. Or... actually, do those still exist? I don't even know. I'm not sure how many fog doors I've... Oh, yes, yes, I remember in certain zones. For example, in Things Betwixt, there are fog doors all over the place. But it... couldn't it have only been there? All other fog doors being bosses? I don't really recall well enough. Skeptic Spice. Here is there. Just lets you fall down. Now, I could jump off there. Try dash, but be wary of jumping. Indeed, I am wary. Also, where are these guys? Because, oh wow. Yet another mushroom enemy. But this time, poison mushrooms. Amanita. Why are there jars and braziers full of poison all over the world? I'm suffering inexplicable frame rate drops. Should go and check whether I'm running out of recording disk space. Probably just something else is happening, but... rubbish. Oh no. Don't tell me I broke the chest and got rubbish. That is a shame. Well, see you in a sec. Yes, I have enough disk space. There is no problem. Not sure what the slowdown was. Perhaps a backup is running or something. So I've basically got two obvious points of progression. I could go through the fog door, or I could try this extremely stupid and dangerous jump. There's absolutely no way I deserve to survive that. Let's do it again. Okay, so I'm not sure if... did I jump from the wrong place there, or did I entirely sail over the platform I was trying to get to and land on the other side of it? Because my goal is to get to there. So perhaps I should simply roll off. Okay. Better. I mean, in retrospect, the message said try dashing but be wary of jumping, so it makes sense that that is clearly a... oof, thank you. What the fuck? Holy shit. What is this? And I hear footsteps such that there might be another one somewhere. Wait. This is a body without a head? Could this... fuck. Damn it, I think it's Vengal's body. No, wait, there's gotta be other people who got decapitated in Drang Lake. It's just that kind of place. But this could be Vengal's body. I'm so excited. And I'm dead also. Okay. Let's try that again. I mean, again. Wow. Look at this guy who's bothering to fight those guys. I mean, there could be... here's what I'm worried about. Down in that area, there could be progression, you know? Could be something useful and interesting and completely relevant to the plot and necessary to get to other areas and so on. But I don't want to walk into a lake of poison. It's a dilemma. I guess I could just kind of keep it at the back of my mind as an option. When I've run out of other places to go, could dive into the Lake of Poison in Harvest Valley. So now, I dash off the edge here. Little too much dashing. Once again, I am freed from the mundane concern of preserving my souls. I think I've lost more souls in Harvest Valley than I had in any other point of the, in the entire rest of the game put together. It's just... It doesn't feel particularly difficult per se. It's not like a super hard zone. But it's got things which just kill you. And they're not obvious things. They're not like this guy hits... Well, no, sometimes they are, like Dark Orb. That was obvious. When the Dark Orb did an enormous amount of damage to me, I can't say I was surprised. Earthen Peak. Wow. Oh, this is what 7 brand new Estus Flasks are for. Having 7 Estus Flasks, by the way, is really nice. It is improving my everything. Just have more leeway. Okay. Why did this happen? Why did that happen that time? So that time when I got down there successfully, what did I do differently? At least I'm getting also type 9. Now, there's a couple of enemies I haven't killed up here, so I've got to be a little careful. Is it because I was running? Why don't I just walk off? That's why. It's jump. Well, not really jump. So, the problem is I fall far enough that I have momentum when I land, and I perform a roll automatically at that point. What if I were to turn it into a plunging attack? You don't have to kill this guy, but you pretty much have to kill the guy directly after him, so it's convenient to kill this guy. And then this one you basically have to kill. That'll bait him out and just go around, at which point you might as well kill him, because it's all hard. And then he's really the only one that you actually have to do to get through here. At least to the point of the jump off. There is one mushroom who is a very good idea to kill him, is this one. Okay, so, run off the edge. Yes! It literally worked perfectly. Excellent. Now, for the bit when a guy comes out to kill me. Oh, he's got a head. He just has extremely bad posture. Alright. You... didn't work like I wanted. I think I lost my lock on. So, his attacks are easily blockable, but he does bleed. Better finish him off fast. Okay, not too bad. I probably should have just treated him like a non-scary enemy and attacked fast for stagger. Yeah, I would characterize this as a standard enemy since there's two of them in the same place. Now, if I stand on this plate thing, an arrow will shoot out of the wall there, so I'll avoid that. Or I guess I could just trigger it to prove to myself that is really what happens. Yes, that is exactly what happens. And... nice try. This one died waiting. What's this? Chest is poison. Back. Huh? What does it mean by back there? Do I jump back? Don't need to do any such thing. Heavy crossbow plus 3. That's cool. If only you could aim them, I'd be really happy about that. Okay, looks like I've done this little area, got the heavy crossbow. Now I want to return to the main part of Earth and Peak and enter the fog door. Which does involve getting down there. In order to not die. But that's actually not too hard, that bit. Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust. And another one's down, and another one's down. Another one bites the dust. Oh, gotta kill the poison. Another one bites the dust. Yeah. I'm actually being led astray a little on these guys, because they're quite easy to backstab, but not that easy. So occasionally, I think I've hit the backstab, and I sort of relax and wait for it to happen, but I haven't hit it. So I was getting lazy then. One more death and I'd be in Ring of Binding territory. Kind of already am, really. But more important. That's completely unintentional. You know how people are like, I meant to do that. Actually, cats are like that more often. Cats will make a mistake and then act like they meant to do it on a regular basis. But humans also do this. Anyway, this is the exact opposite. I didn't mean to do that. Why aren't you fighting me? Ah, stupidity. Oh, two ones for some reason. I don't remember this happening. Thankfully, these are one of the easier kinds of enemies to attack 2-on-1, as they don't really bunch up or stand on opposite sides of you or anything like that. They're damaging but not armored. It's armored enemies who you can't kill fast that are particularly dangerous to fight in large groups. In fact, these guys are so completely unarmored. They don't even wear shirts. So I've been in there and I'm not going back. Instead. Well, what do you know? I should really just start associating fog doors with boss fights. Outside of that one time in Things Betwixt. Ugh. He might be about to do something. Can't guess them all. Wow. I've been completely owned this turn of events. So I'm literally going to use an Estus Flask and a Life Gem. So much that he's breathing out. Nasty stuff. So I'm thinking you actually want to kind of stand in... Fuck. At least I didn't get poisoned, so I'm kind of not dead yet. But I'm about to be. Okay, so don't get hit by the jump, and you're in better shape than if you do. That makes sense. Unpleasant to look at. And now he's dead. Okay. Covetous demon soul, you say? Covetous demon that devours all things. Whoa. So this is literally a men's rights activist? Yep. Doesn't surprise me a lot. I came from there. I could go here or here. In fact, that looks like the coolest by far. Oh. How did they get there? I see. Are you freaking kidding me? So if it's not clear, I'm trying to run, but there's a sort of invisible wall here. So... it's like an Escher diagram. But it looks like you can get up there, but maybe you can't? Maybe this room was redesigned at some point. Offends me. So I'll go somewhere else immediately. Hang on. Why is this pot thing here with spikes? Maybe if you can get the guy to throw himself into that, he damages himself. Who knows? Anyway, the covetous demon is dead. Lucatiel! Oh man, I wonder if I could have summoned her.
Still on the road.
Yep.
Sorry to have burdened you, sir.
No, no, it's no problem.
This is for you.
Thank you.
I found my thoughts growing hazy.
Oh shit, you need effigies.
My memories are fading. Oldest first.
No.
The curse is doing its work upon me. I am frightened. Terribly so.
Cool hat.
I had an older brother. We learned to fence together. He became the most decorated swordsman in the world of Mira. I never even compared to him. In fact, I never beat him. Not once. Then, one day, he was gone. Lost without a trace. Now I'm certain that he was taken by the curse.
That sucks.
If only someone would hear my tale. My brother must have come here, too. Soon I may forget even about him.
I've met one other guy from Mira. He was a warrior who got betrayed by Pate. I don't know, he didn't seem much like Lugatil, though.
If only someone, my brother, soon I.
I mean, there's some bad shit going on. And she's gone. I'm gonna go human in case there's a summon sign later. Lugatil is my friend. Well, I don't know about it. She needs a friend. Blythe might be enough of an idiot to not need friends. Lower Earthen Peak. What do we have here? Well, a deep well full of poison, of course. Why wouldn't you put something like that in place? And the workings of a windmill. That's cool. Try ranged battle. Why should I try ranged battle? Melee battle has been working quite well so far. Except for those ogres. Still not seeing much of an incentive. Some people need to get their sword on. Oh. Is this why I should try ranged battle? I see. I guess I was unduly dismissive of this idea. I'll try ranged battle. It was fairly successful. Unfortunately, there's another one. So, who or what is this guy? He's cool, I guess. Like, got a nice spear that doesn't do much, but it glows. I appreciate that. Grave Warden cuffs. Just what is so grave about the... Ah! Ruined my joke. This feels kind of like using a dagger all over again. I think I can get to the guy that way. No? How did he come and attack me already? Fair enough. This is an interesting place. Sometimes they are helpful. Sometimes they are liars. Pike. Where does this go? Up. Oh, fog. Lots of fog. Wouldn't be too surprised if there's a big fight up there. Okay, so, about this. Don't quite understand the relevance of that. Windmill. Let's try this again. I have fire arrows. Try the fire arrows. What is the point of putting that pot on the ceiling? I've done it, I'm not taking it back now, but what was the point? I think I'm out of fire drums now, so I'll have to try fire arrows. Bonfire ahead. I'm not sure that's accurate. I mean, it could be. There could be a bonfire there. Although it could be a boss fight, as there usually is after a fog door. Black firebomb. That's handy. Even I was just going, I would like to burn something but don't have firebombs. So I've definitely been given a reader tip. Lies. I've generally been given a reader tip that it is occasionally useful to burn things. And I found that one place where I was able to burn a rope and get a thing out of a well. So, I would like to burn this windmill, but I don't know if I know how. Oh. I see. Is it gonna come crashing down again? Let's find out. Yes. Well, that's nasty. Oh, man. Ah, but you can get across to there and then you're safe. Oh, have to try that in a bit. Even when I'm not carrying 20,000 souls. Attacking ahead. Oh! Simple to the spice. Look, if there's anywhere I can smash this thing from, it's going to be here. I'll try one of those big firebombs. Place kind of goes on. What's this? Huh. That's interesting. Given this place kind of goes on, I'm now reevaluating whether in fact that fog door is going to be a boss fight or not. Ah. It's just, I don't have a good history with messages that say bonfire ahead. I really don't. Now I've got a better one. My history has improved. Which makes this a good place for a recording break.